Good morning. I'm Dr. G.V.M. Sharma, working here as an associate professor in the Department of MBA and Research Center. I'm also an in charge for the Center of Excellence, which we have started a couple of years back. And I have totally 26 years of teaching experience and 4 years of industry experience. And basically, I'm a commerce graduate. And later, I did my MBA and MCOM and PGDPM. And I completed my doctorate from VTU. So this is my big introduction about myself.
Welcome sir to another episode on Thoughts on Education conducted by collegedunia.com. So starting with the first question here, so being the in charge of Center of Excellence wing, so what are your roles and responsibilities towards the students, sir?
Okay, so as a COE team in our department, our major roles are coordinate with the companies for collaboration,
yeah,
and scheduling and the conduction of the programs to our students.
Mm-hmm.
And presently we are offering 8 certification programs.
Okay.
Data science, design thinking, artificial intelligence, cyber security, and quantum, blockchain, and cloud computing.
Great.
These are the courses we are offering right now.
Okay, sir. So how does the collaboration with different companies help students in their future, sir?
So definitely having collaboration with the companies, get to know the current need of the industry and offer the programs accordingly. So this definitely helps our students to go for very high profile jobs as they are already trained.
Mm-hmm.
Because most of our faculty team from the COE are the mastery certified people.
Mm-hmm.
Who will come and train our students.
Yeah.
They handhold our students to the extent possible so that it will be easy for the students to go for occupying the high profile jobs.
Okay, sir. So, how does the curriculum of RNSIT MBA ensure the best practice of the industry, sir?
To say in brief, basically, industry look at the one major component, that is a skill set.
Mm-hmm.
So, the required skill set. I'm sure RNSIT MBA imparting all necessary skill set as required by the industry. So we at RNSIT, we have varieties of programs to impart the quality of education and skill set right from the beginning till the completion of the course. We are offering many programs, such as we are offering Excel programs, we are offering English communication classes.
Mm-hmm.
Then we have outbound activities in our department. We'll send our students to world-class institute like Pegasus, etc.
Mm-hmm.
And we also offer a field employable program to the students in addition to various placement training programs.
Okay.
In between, n number of webinars, n number of workshops, guest lectures, all these things happening in the department.
Okay.
Definitely, I'm sure we have a very good practice in our department, which will help our students to meet the industry requirements.
Okay, great, sir. So how does the curriculum and any insight into how your university could be more welcoming to the student of different races and economic backgrounds, sir?
So you mean to say that Vishwasharya Technological University?
Yeah.
Okay. So basically, Vishwasharya Technological University also take an initiative to offer analytical programs.
Yeah.
So in the last curriculum itself, they have introduced marketing analytics and HR analytics.
Mm-hmm.
I think university has to get ready with develop the resources basically, and then they need to offer the courses across the state.
Mm-hmm.
So I feel university already taken this important element.
I think they are
in the right direction.
Okay. So sir, what do you think your roles and responsibilities to the students and our departments are, sir?
So our roles towards the students basically is to make our students to understand the significance of the certification program basically.
Mm-hmm.
So unless and until they understand the importance of the programs, so they may not go for the enrollment.
Mm-hmm.
So we are motivating our students to enroll the programs.
Mm-hmm.
And later we will track their learning curve. Then we will arrange for the assessment.
Mm-hmm.
And we help them to get the global certification.
Okay.
Once they get the global certification, the world-class institutes the IBM will put their resume in the global board. Definitely, it will help them to get a good opportunity.
Okay. And sir, how do you influence the student to take those certification programs, sir?
So, there will be continuous evaluation and there will be a continuous test and continuous, it will help them to go for continuous practices.
Mm-hmm.
And they have their own trials. So they can do a lot of tests and they can get a practice before go for the final assessment.
Okay.
And our faculty members also, most of our faculty got mastery certifications over the programs. They got business analytics and predictive analytics courses.
Yeah.
Definitely our faculty team also helped them to motivate and they're helping their
So, sir, what do you see as RNSIT MBA's greatest strengths, sir?
So, our strengths are, to be frank, many. So, in my experience with RNSIT MBA, the utmost care we have taken for the discipline.
Mm-hmm.
And our faculty strengths are excellent. We have a mix of industry and academic. Our average experience of a faculty is around 12 to 13 years.
Okay, okay. Great.
So we have two alumni of IIMs, one from IIMC and IIMB professor are working.
Mm-hmm.
And topmost experienced people are working as visiting faculty.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And our team captain basically is a great leader.
Okay.
So that is our greatest strength.
Mm-hmm.
And definitely we have a cordial atmosphere in the department.
Yeah.
And we have a strong R&D activities in our department.
Yes.
So we used to offer our research scholars for the review meeting. We are invited the people from the ISEC, IIMs and IISc.
Okay.
So definitely these are the great strengths.
Sure. So sir, what are some of the biggest challenges you see especially for your department, sir?
So right now, I think we have to go in the direction of adding some more MOUs with the other top institutes, other organizations, and extending our certification programs to a diverse crowd, like corporate executives, alumni group, and other than RNSIT degree students.
Mm-hmm.
So we are planning in that direction.
Okay.
So definitely these are the challenges for us.
Sure. So, how do you tend to establish a healthy relationship with the visiting companies in your college, sir?
So, usually whenever the company visited to our department, so we have, we try to project our work culture.
Mm-hmm.
We are exhibiting our, we are showcasing our talents.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever the programs we are offering here, we try to bring their notice.
Mm-hmm.
And definitely it is help us to have a good relationship with the industry.
Mm-hmm.
And we are involving industry professionals in most of our activities.
Yeah.
So definitely we have a good relationship with them.
Mm-hmm.
So this is the perspective.
Okay, great, sir. So one last question, sir. Yes. So any insight, any suggestion you would like to give to the current youth and aspiring students so that they can have a prosperous career ahead, sir?
Okay. As a senior faculty of the department, what I would like to say, these days I have seen different categories of students.
Yeah.
And so in my view, they have to go with the VGA DEVO formula. V indicates vision.
Okay.
Students have to set their vision. They have to decide what they want to become.
Exactly.
Second point, goal setting. So they have to set a short-term goals and a long-term goals without which they cannot go further.
Yeah.
Once they set a goals, the third component is the action plan.
Mm-hmm.
So they have to prepare the action plan to achieve the goals.
Yeah.
And the fourth component is a dedication. So they have to execute the plans.
Mm-hmm.
So with their dedications.
Yeah.
And finally, observe.
Mm-hmm.
So they must observe what are the changes happening in the industry.
Exactly.
Then only it is possible for the students to go and occupy the high position and survive in this competitive one.
Yeah.
So this is my words for the youngest student.
Great, sir. So it was great having you with us in this interview, which is Thoughts on Education conducted by College Duniya. So I believe the student who will be viewing this interview, they'll be getting some insight from your vision as well as the vision you have for RNSIT MBA department. And I believe they'll get some of the insight from here, and they'll make their informed decision to whether to join which colleges and all. So thank you again, sir. Thank you for your time with us.
Thank you so much. Thank you for